trainer. My father's name is Siva. He's the operation manager. They are standing over there. Please say hi to them. The title of my poem is The Tale of Custard the Dragon. Belinda lived in a little white house with a little black kitten and a little grey mouse and a little yellow dog and a little red wagon and a really old, truly old little pet dragon. Now the name of the little black kitten was Ink and the little grey mouse she called her Blink and the little yellow dog was sharp as mustard but the dragon was a coward and she called him Custard. Custard the dragon had big sharp teeth and spikes on top of him and scales underneath. Mouth like a fireplace, chimney for a nose and really old, truly old daggers on his toes. Belinda was as brave as a barrel full of bears. Ink and Blink chased lions down the stairs. Mustard was as brave as a tiger in a rage. But Custard cried for a nice, safe cage. Belinda tickled him. She tickled him unmercifully. Ink, Blink and Mustard rudely called him Percival. They all sat laughing in the little red wagon at the really old, truly old little pet dragon. Belinda giggled till she shook the house. Blink said wink, which is giggling for a mouse. Ink and Mustard rudely asked his age when Custard cried for a nice safe cage. Suddenly they heard a nasty sound. Mustard growled and they all looked around. Meow cried Ink and ooh cried Belinda, for there was a pirate climbing in the window. Pistol in his left hand and pistol in his right. And in his teeth, he held a cutlass bright. His beard was black, one leg was wood. It was clear that the pirate meant no good. Belinda paled and she cried, "Help! Help!" And Mustard fled with a terrified yell. Ink trickled out to the bottom of the household and Little Mouse Blink strategically mousehold. But up jumped Custard, snorting like an engine, clashed his tail like iron in a dungeon. With a clatter and a clank and a jangling swirl, he went at the pirate like a robin at a worm. The pirate came at Belinda's dragon and gulped some grog from his pocket flagon. He fired two bullets, but they didn't hit, and Custard gobbled in every bit. Belinda embraced him. Mustard licked him. No one mourned for his pirate victim. Ink and Blink eagerly gyrated around the dragon that ate the pirate. But presently out spoke little dog Mustard. "I would have been twice as brave if I hadn't flustered." And out spoke Ink and out spoke Blink. "He would have been three times as brave, we think." And Custard said, "I quite agree that everybody is braver than me." Belinda still lived in a little white house with a little black kitten and a little grey mouse. And a little yellow dog and a little red wagon and a really old, truly old little pet dragon. Belinda was as brave as a barrel full of bears. Ink and Blink chased lions down the stairs. Mustard was as brave as a tiger in a rage. But Custard cried for a night.